Stop expecting. Start accepting. Life becomes much easier. Welcome back to our channel. Today's lecture is on a very important topic which was requested by many of our viewers. It is a long answer question which is asked in exam, the malignant melanoma. So, the malignant melanoma is a neoplasm of the epidermal melanocytes. It is biologically unpredictable lesion which is deadly in nature, and it is the third most common cancer of the skin. It occurs mostly in the whites, and it may develop from a pre-existing nevi, or malignant melanoma may also occur de novo in the skin. Now, the precursor lesions of malignant melanoma include acquired nevus, dysplastic nevus, congenital nevus, and cellular blue nevus. We have already uploaded a lecture on the nevus, intraoral nevus. So go through that lecture. You will have a basic idea of all these types of nevus. Now, the etiology of malignant melanoma. There are two types of factors responsible for the occurrence of malignant melanoma: the environmental factors and the genetic factors. Now, talking about the environmental factors, sun exposure is a primary cause of malignant melanoma. Increase in the exposure of ultraviolet radiation may cause malignant melanoma. Artificial sources of UV or the ultraviolet light, mainly the longer wavelength ultraviolet light, causes malignant melanoma. Also, the PUVA therapy, which is nothing but a combination of soralin and long wave ultraviolet radiation, increases the risk of malignant melanoma. Then, socioeconomic status plays a role. Those people with higher socioeconomic status who can afford holiday in areas with increased UV exposure are more prone. Then, people with fair skin, freckles and red hair are prone, and certain melanocytic nevi may be a precursor for malignant melanoma. Now, the genetic factors. Familial melanoma occurs in 2-5% cases. The defective gene is on 9p21. Those people with the condition xeroderma pigmentosum, in which there is defective DNA repair, are at a higher risk of malignant melanoma. Other risk factors for malignant melanoma include chemical, physical, and thermal insults to the skin. Now, the developmental biology of malignant melanoma, very important. Clark and co-workers have described the developmental biology of malignant melanoma in two phases, the radial growth phase and the vertical growth phase. In radial growth phase, this is the initial phase and it occurs for many years. The lesions spread in the epidermis. Also, the melanoma cells are shed off from the skin, and the host immune mechanism play a major role in the radial growth phase, as the neoplastic cells which try to penetrate the basement membrane are destroyed by the host immune mechanism. While the vertical growth phase, the neoplastic cells, they invade the basement membrane and accumulate in the dermis. There is increased virulence reported in the neoplastic cells. The host cell response is reduced and metastasis has been reported. Now, nodular melanoma has only the vertical growth phase. Remember, this is an MCQ question. Nodular melanoma is a kind of melanoma in which there is only vertical growth phase. So, here you can see the radial growth phase and the vertical growth phase. The radial growth phase, in which the neoplastic cells are present only in the epidermis, While in the vertical growth phase, these neoplastic cells have crossed the membrane or the basement membrane and entered into the underlying dermis. Now, the classification of malignant melanoma, there are six types. Easy mnemonic to remember, MALA says no. So, six types of the malignant melanomas. First type is the superficial spreading. Second is the nodular type. Then comes the lentigo maligna type. Then the acral lentiginous melanoma. Then comes the mucosal lentiginous melanoma and the amelanotic melanoma. Now the clinical features. First, talking about the superficial spreading melanoma, it accounts 65% of all the malignant melanomas. In its radial growth phase, which is also called as melanoma in situ, it appears as tan, brown or black or an admixed lesion. While in the vertical growth phase, there is increase in the size of the lesion, change in color and nodularity occurs in the lesion. So this is a classical picture of superficial spreading melanoma in its radial growth phase. Now, nodular melanoma is a type of melanoma which shows only vertical growth. 13% of the lesions are nodular melanoma. It appears clinically as a sharply delineated nodule, showing varying pigmentation from pink to black color. So, here is a classical case of nodular melanoma. Then comes the lentigo maligna melanoma, which accounts for 10% of the lesions. This melanoma has more of the radial growth. The other name for lentigo maligna melanoma is the melanotic freckle of Hutchinson. So, remember this alternative name of lentigo maligna melanoma is melanotic freckle of Hutchinson. Females are affected more than the males. This lentigo maligna melanoma appears as a macular lesion on the malar eminence, on the eyes, on the mucous membranes, and sometimes also the parotid gland is involved. So here you can see the lentigo maligna melanoma showing the radial growth phase, and it is present on the malar eminence of this female patient. Now, what is subungual melanoma? It is a pigmented melanoma which is very aggressive and rapidly progressive. It shows both the radial and vertical growth phase, in which you can see pigmentation in the nail bed. Now comes the mucosal lentiginous melanoma, which accounts only 3% of the lesion, and this type of melanoma may occur in the respiratory tract mucosa, GI tract mucosa or in the genital tract. It occurs in advanced age, it is highly aggressive, and diagnosis of the lesion occurs at a very advanced stage. So here you can see the mucosal melanoma in the intraoral region. In the mouth you can see this is the mucosal melanoma. Now comes the amelanotic melanoma. It is erythematous pink eroded nodule. So here you can see amelanotic melanoma. Amelanotic yani without any pigmentation. So it is amelanotic. Now there is a set of rule called as ABCDE rule for the diagnosis of malignant melanoma. Very important to remember this ABCDE rule. Let us see what is this ABCDE rule. When you come across a pigmented lesion, see the five criteria. A for asymmetry, B for the border irregularity, C is for the color irregularity, D is for the diameter of the lesion, and E whether elevation is present or no. So this is the ABCDE rule. Now the oral manifestation of malignant melanoma. Males are affected more than the females, and it occurs at a mean age of 55 years. Most common intraoral site is palate, maxillary gingiva and the alveolar ridge. It appears as a deeply pigmented area which may be ulcerated, there may be hemorrhage. The amelanotic intraoral melanoma appears as a white mucosa colored lesion. So intraoral melanoma has both the radial as well as vertical growth phase. Most common kind of intraoral melanoma are superficial spreading melanoma, acral lentiginous melanoma and nodular melanoma. So here you can see an intraoral melanoma. Now histopathology of malignant melanoma. The malignant cells, they appear as in nests or in clusters and they are arranged in an organoid fashion. The melanoma cells are spindle shaped cells with large nuclei, prominent nucleoli, and nuclear pseudo inclusions are a common finding in these melanoma cells. These nuclear pseudo inclusions is because of the irregular nuclear membrane. Also, the melanoma cells have abundant cytoplasm. So here you can see this is the typical melanoma cell showing large nuclei, prominent nucleoli, abundant cytoplasm. Now, the histopathology of superficial spreading melanoma. In the superficial spreading melanoma, the melanoma cells are confined only to the epithelium. There is no connective tissue response. The growth is totally in the radial phase. So here you can see the melanoma cells present only in the epidermis and there is no connective tissue response. Now, these superficial spreading melanoma show a characteristic feature which is very important. You should remember this. There is a presence of large epitheloid melanocytes that are arranged in a pagetoid manner. Now, what is this pagetoid manner? This pagetoid manner is a terminology which describes that the spread of the cells is in the epithelium. And it is confined to the epithelium, not in the connective tissue. So this is called as pagetoid manner of growth. This is also called as buckshot scatter. So here you should remember two terminology. What is pagetoid manner and buckshot scatter, which is found in superficial spreading melanoma, characteristic feature. So here you can see the malignant melanocytes. See here, this is the malignant melanocyte, this is the malignant melanocyte. These are nests of these melanocytes and they are arranged in a pagetoid manner, that is only into the epidermis. And here you can see the buckshot scatter in which the melanocytes have almost replacing the epidermis. Now, vertical growth phase of this superficial spreading melanoma occurs when the malignant cells cross the basement membrane and reach the connective tissue. Now comes the nodular melanoma. Large epitheloid melanocytes are seen in the connective tissue. Some ovoid and spindle cells may also be seen. And malignant pigments may be seen. So here you can see this is the melanin pigment and melanocytes in the connective tissue, and this connective tissue has shown large amount of response by showing chronic inflammatory cell infiltration in response to these melanocytes. Now comes the lentigo maligna melanoma. In lentigo maligna melanoma, there is increase in the number of atypical melanocytes in the basal layer. The epithelium becomes atrophic. There is some damage to the dermal collagen. This is called as basophilic degeneration. Now, there are cords of atypical melanocytes, invasive spindle cells and lymphohistiocytic infiltration in the connective tissue. So here you can see cords of atypical melanocytes in this lesion of lentigo maligna melanoma. Now, the acral lentiginous melanoma, this acral lentiginous melanoma show histologic features similar to lentigo maligna melanoma. It has both the radial as well as deep vertical growth phase. Spindle cells are present, psoriasiform epidermal hypoplasia is present, desmoplasia is present, and intense host cell response is reported. So here you can see all the features of acral lentiginous melanoma. So the treatment of this is surgical excision combined with chemotherapy, immunotherapy, and radiotherapy. So this is the discussion on malignant melanoma, which is a very important long answer question. Get thorough with this topic if you don't want to lose any marks. That's all for now. Happy studying.